Hi everybody, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and this is a little update on my pond aeration. I wanted to show you what I had done down here to the pond since the last time you've seen it. I dug it out a lot deeper and added some hills out there. Pretty cool. So, here's a problem I found with pond aeration and using these types of aerators. One's just a rod and the other type's the ring. Which one do I prefer? Guess it doesn't really matter. And I'll show you what they're all doing. Okay, to give you an idea of what the bubbles should be looking like that come out of these aerators, it should be very fine, very tiny bubbles that come out of an aerator. Not large, huge bubbles if you've made something on your own, because they don't work. You need millions of tiny little air bubbles, and you'll see this one here. Works very well. So what I found over time was when I hooked my hose to the aerator ring, this is a diffuser, by the way. These are called diffusers. This is a round diffuser, and this is the same thing, only in a rod. What I'd found is when I threw the diffuser out into the water, it floats to the bottom. Sets in the mud. Now they're still working just fine, but here's what happens. When your aeration system shuts down, when your pump shuts down, what happens is mud backflows into all of these tiny little holes and eventually starts clogging these aerators up. And I noticed that over time the bubbles were getting less and less and less. And then eventually, the one way out there that goes to SunTac stopped working altogether. So what I did is I disconnect the hose right off the pump. I took an air hose, put it into it, and blasted them out. And I had about a small little air tank, and that's all that it took to work. And it blew out all of the mud and debris that built up in these things. They went right back to working. Now, some people have suggested a check valve in the line, but that really doesn't work. They still allow mud to get into the pores. So I've come up with a simple solution to keep these off the floor of the pond. I simply put a wire mesh screen around them, and it worked. You just throw them out in the water, no matter how they land. They never sit on the floor of the pond. Okay, here it is. Here's my diffuser. And I had some old tomato cages. You know, the types that you stick in the ground, tomatoes grow up through. And this is what I did. I just bent the cage around it, and it worked just fine. Now, you could take a roll of chicken wire or something like that and just roll it two or three or four times, some zip ties together, anything. And that chicken wire would hit the floor of the pond, your diffuser would be up off the floor, and it'd go back to working just fine. Anyway, these are working beautifully. I'm not going to have to pump them out again or blow them out again. So it doesn't matter really how you throw it out in the water. It's going to work just fine. There we go. Boy, look at that dude boil. Now here's the old aerator ring, and it finally got plugged up enough to where it wasn't working worth a darn, so I replaced it. Now check out the new one. Okay, you notice how I just replaced the ring on that. Look at how the water is boiling. That's the way they should be working them. My other ones were a few years old, and they finally got plugged up by laying on the bottom of the pond. Now, if you'll pan over here to the left, these are also old rings, and they eventually started getting plugged up because they laid on the pond floor, and they should be actually boiling. Not like this. They should be like that one out there. the new one that I just replaced. Well, I'm Jeff from Missouri Wind and Solar, and I hope you like this little update on how to maintain and clean your diffusers. Like I said, you can air hose these out, works just fine.